Let's move on to the next example. This is a word problem. You may encounter these types of problems, especially like on an SAT or something. So let's go ahead and get started. So you are planning what to do after school. You have 6 hours for basketball and homework. So the combined is 6 hours for both. You can play a maximum of 2 hours of basketball. You must do at least 1 hour of homework. What is a graph showing how you can spend your time? This is actually, although you would not do this probably to determine how much homework you should do, these are types of constraint problems that you would see in the business field when they have inputs and outputs, products to be sold, customer demand. So this is relevant in that way. And they actually do graphs like these to find out the most efficient processes within their business setting. So you have 6 hours of basketball and homework. Well, we already have some variables here. Let's call... it already has here that X should be hours of basketball. So let's put X equals hours of, I'm going to put B-ball. And then we have Y equals hours of homework. Okay? So if you have 6 hours, that means you can't spend any more than that, but you could spend less time than 6 hours for those two things. So we know that X plus Y, okay, the time we spend playing basketball and the time we spend with homework can be less than or equal to 6 hours. Okay, so the time you spend playing basketball and the time you spend on homework can be less than or equal to 6 hours. Okay, you could spend less time than that, but you can't spend any more than six, so it has to be less than six. Now let's talk about basketball. The fun stuff first. You can play a maximum of 2 hours, okay? So time playing basketball. Now, does that mean it can be bigger than 2 hours? No, it has to be less than. So it can be equal to 2 hours. So we have X is less than or equal to 2. You must do at least 1 hour of homework. So if we have to do at least 1 hour of homework, that means we can spend 1 hour doing homework, or we can spend 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours. As long as it's bigger than one, you're fine, okay? But you have to spend at least 1 hour doing homework. So Y has to be greater than or equal to 1 hour, okay? Now, what do you notice? Well, we have a system of inequalities. I know we haven't done three inequalities yet, but it's going to be the same process we've been doing with two. So let's start with one. The first thing I'm going to do with number one is let's pick colors for all of these. I already have purple for two. I have green for three. So I'm going to choose blue for number one. And what I need to do here is I need to solve for Y because it makes it a lot easier to graph. So the first thing I'm going to do, rewrite it. Okay, and then I'm going to solve for Y. I'm going to get Y by itself. So I have Y is less than or equal to 6 minus X because I subtracted X by from both sides to get the Y alone. And there I have it in slope-intercept form. Let's go ahead and graph it. So I recognize that negative 1 is my slope, and then positive 6 is my y-intercept. So 6 equals my y-intercept. So I'm going to go over here to my line, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Always start with your y-intercept, and now I'm going to use my slope, and I am just going to start graphing. Now, notice one thing that's going to be easy. Because it's all less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, we're going to have solid lines for all of these, okay? So that makes it a little bit easier. We don't have to worry about doing the dotted or dashed line. Let's go ahead and draw that. There we go. Okay, next up, we're going to draw the X equals 2. This is a special case. Notice how it's not in slope-intercept form. This is a special case because this is a vertical line. Okay, this is a vertical line. So what I'm going to do is I go over to X equals 2, which is here. Okay, now I'm talking about all the values where X is 2. X is 2 here, X is 2 here, X is 2 here, X is 2 here, X is 2 here. I hope you get the idea. There's lots of X's, and we need to represent all of them with this line. So what we have to do is we need to graph a solid vertical line here. Okay, there we go. And then lastly, we have Y is greater than or equal to 1. This is not necessarily a special case. This is already in slope-intercept form. But notice that your slope is 0 and your y-intercept is 1, okay? This is a horizontal line. Anytime it's y equals a number, it's a horizontal line. So I'm going to go to y equals 1, and this is talking about all the values where y equals 1. So I'm just putting dots. You don't have to do this. I'm just showing you where y equals 1 and why it's a horizontal line. Those values are all y equals 1, and there I go. Okay, now I'm not done. This is, I essentially drew a system of equations. This is a system of inequalities, so I need to start shading. So let's start with the blue one again. Notice how it is less than or equal to, so that means I shade below. So I'm going to go to my blue one, and I am going to completely ignore the other lines that I've drawn, and I'm just going to shade below this line, okay, like this. Okay, anywhere it's below. Again, some people find it hard to know what is below the line. Just pick any point of the line and then pick something underneath it, and it's got to be shaded in that area. All right, so we're done with the first part. Now we need to do x is less than or equal to 2. Now, here's the problem. This is not in our normal form where it's y is less than. X is less than or equal to 2. I talked about this in the other video, but we need to, if it's x is less than, it's shade left. If it's x is greater than, it's shade right. If you're ever confused on which way to shade, we can always just test a point. For example, if we test the point 0, 0, we're going to plug in 0 for x and 0 for y into here. Well, there's no y, so the only thing you're going to plug in is 0. So 0 is less than or equal to 2. Is that a true statement? Yes, it is. So we are going to include that point in our shading. So let me get my purple shader, and you'll notice that with 0, 0, I'm shading to the left. So I talked about this in the other video too. If you're confused on this, I went over it kind of quickly just now, but that is how, sorry, a little picky with my shading. Okay, shade to the left, looks like this. Okay. Finally, we're shading in green, and we have y is greater than or equal to 1. We already know that if it's greater than, if y is greater than, we're shade above the line. So I go to y equals 1. I completely ignore the other ones, and I'm just going to worry about shading above the line. Y is greater than 1, and there I go. Okay. Now, what is the solution? The solution is where all the points overlap. So you can kind of see that the points are all going to overlap in this trapezoid shaped region here. Okay, all the points overlap in this region. Now, in the context of the problem, you wouldn't, so if you guys did this for the solution, I'd be okay with it. But keep in mind, if we're talking about this problem, we can't go into the negative territory. Why? Well, because you can't have negative hours of homework or negative hours of basketball. So we would want to be worried about only this area. Okay, so this is the realm of possibilities of how he can spend his time doing homework or basketball. I hope you found this video helpful, and I will see you next time.